Okay, welcome to issue 58 of the R2-D2 build. This week, it's quite a simple issue. We'll be putting that panel into the dome, and we'll be putting the base on R2's leg. And there's only one page of instructions this week. There's quite a lengthy article about BB-8 in here, which you might enjoy reading. And we actually have one page of instructions. That's it. I think with all the articles they've put in this week's magazine, they've kind of run out of space for the build instructions. And that's all you get this week. Put that in there and put that on there. It's as simple as that. So, let's get cracking. I'm actually going to do it in reverse order. Just because I've got the leg handy. Putting the base of the leg on, it's really simple. It can only go on one way. It's identical to the assembly of the other leg. And it's held in place by six of the black self-tapping screws. We've got a bag of those this week. It's always easier to use a magnetic screwdriver for this job, of course. You also get the power cables in this issue, but you won't use those until next week. The power bus cables, I think they're called, but they'll be fitted when you get the other components next week. I think fitting the base of the foot is going to be a lot easier than fitting that panel into the dome. We shall see. Right. Let's get that on the end of the screwdriver. As I said, a magnetic screwdriver, you really do need one for this kit. These tiny screws are a little awkward to work with. Okay, there we are. That's the base of the foot fitted. You can see the infrared emitter and detector there. There's no little spacer underneath this one. If you remember, we had to put a little calibration plate in the other leg, but there's no mention of that. This time around, so I'm sure there's a method in the madness. So that's the first stage anyway, the base of the foot's fitting. And now we move over to the dome. This is the bit I'm getting less and less fond of, using this sticky tape that they provide. I find this very awkward to work with. I know I've said it before, but it's I'm sure they could have done this better. You know, they could have used an adhesive, or they could have used some other method of fitting it. There's no actual instructions this week on precisely how to do it. They just say use the tape to fit the panel into the hole. And like I say, they seem to be a bit short on space this week, so that's all the instructions you get. Right. Bear in mind that the panel is going next to the circular hole. The panel's going next to the panel we fitted last time. There's a circular hole, and then that's where the panel's going in. Okay. And if you get stuck, you can always compare it with the illustration there. So, let's try and get these bits of tape into position. And they're quite long ones, these. Have to be quite careful with it. I think I've done this so many times now, I am actually getting the hang of it. That one's gone on without incident. Okay, and the second one. The article on BB-8, incidentally, is worth reading, and I would recommend you have a look at that, because in my opinion, the articles haven't really been very good, but that one's worth having a look at. Is worth reading. Okay. So it's slight twisting now, I'm just gonna do that again. Quite long pieces of tape this week, so extra fiddly to deal with. Can have two or three goes to it. This top one is quite difficult, has to be said. Ah, there we go, that's got it. There we go. Right, now this is the really tricky part, getting the backing off. Try using the edge of the screwdriver, see if that helps. As I said last week, probably a really sharp pair of scissors or the edge of a sharp pair of tweezers is probably the best way of doing this. But, it's still tricky stuff to work with. Yeah, that's about it. There we go. Second bit. Is that covered? No, not quite. It's got the end bit. And there we go. Right. Thank heavens that's done. Right. The slot is going uppermost, as you can see. And don't get it in the wrong way up. Lined up nice and square. There we go. There is a tiny amount of movement in these panels, so you can just tweak them a little. Panel in place. So that's it. That's it for issue 58. Was that issue 58? It certainly was. So there we are. That's the panel in place and the base of the foot in place as well. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you for issue 59, which is a bit longer and a bit more interesting. So thanks for watching.